Good evening, guys. This is the race result for 200 miles. Okay, we got 72nd place and 132nd place out of the combine. There's 184 birds. There's 12 lofts, and Pueblo City kicked their butts. They dominated a lot of pages. Therefore, even though my birds came back pretty quick, they are all the way in the back. But yeah, congratulations to the first place winners. The top five, first place, 1,225 yards per minute. Congratulations. They clocked in at 11:20. Congratulations, winners. All the birds came in at 1,200 yards, above 200 yards per minute, and that's a very good thing. Congratulations to Ray Ratovic from Pueblo City and Dave Dudley for getting the birds in the top pages. Therefore, pushing our birds all the way to the back. Our birds, 72nd place, 1,006 yards per minute, clocking in over an hour behind theirs, 12 o'clock, 34 minutes. And on the second day, another bird came back, 132nd place. And then shortly after, we turned off the clocks. So, out of 184 birds, 133 birds came back. We lost 4 birds in this race. We don't know what happened because we're thinking that the birds probably got shot or whatever else because we trained our birds from 110 miles and 60 miles several times. And they've flown from 110, 160 miles, no problem. They raced no problem from that mileage, but at the 200 mileage, they didn't come home. So we're thinking that they probably got shot by hunters. And we're doing our best to try to change the dates so that young bird season can be like a month early before hunting season begins for dove season, so that we can reduce the losses of our birds. So yeah, we're going to talk about that a little more later.
This is our first bird that came in. And the sorry part about this is that she only got 9 flights now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. See, the 8th flight came in and the 9th flight is still here. Or the 10th flight, but it seems like she's missing a flight. I think she's missing the 9th or 10th flight on this side. And then as this side, she still has all 10 flights, but the 8th flight is still here. So it seems like the 9th flight on this side has molted out. So that's probably going to be a setback for her. She's probably not going to win the race this weekend, but definitely we're counting on her to finish the race. It's going to be a 250 miles race this weekend. And then the eyes.
Excuse me. And then the eyes, same thing. They got like a bunch of like little squiggly lines out of the on the outer rings of the pupil. The other birds didn't have this. The other birds was more clearer and more cleaner. But these ones, they have a very, very, they have that, all those like an outer layer of around the pupil of squiggly lines. And I think that's probably something about their vision. They could probably see a little bit better. But, all right. And this, okay. And then this, the pink on the breast meat indicates that they're good, that they're having enough carbs and protein and not overdoing on protein. So, all right, I'll show you guys this, okay? So, one of the YouTubers was telling me about the breast meat, that if it's pink like this, then they're good. But if it's dark purple or purple, then that means they have too much protein or something. We gotta line up to feed, but as of right now, the color of this breast meat seems okay. This is the bird that came the second day. He's pretty fat and healthy now. Today is Wednesday. And we're going for a 30-mile toss today just to get them some exercise. All 10 flights are in. This one's on an 8th flight. Okay. My birds, these ones, they're probably not going to be my best birds, but this year, we're not counting on them to win. We're just counting on them to finish the race.
but it's dove season, and that's the only thing that we're afraid of, that dove season might not do them so well. So next year we're trying to push for the, next year we're going to try to push for the pigeon race to start like at least 3 or 4 weeks ahead of dove season, from the 100 to 200 miles. And then after dove season, or 2 weeks of before the end of dove season, or a week before the end of dove season, then we'll start from the 200 or, you know, onto the 350 miles. So yeah, the first 4 weeks we're trying to push for like 100 to 250 miles, and then we're going to relax the birds because they're going to be in molt and whatever else, and then we're going to try to restart 2 weeks before, or a week before, or after the dove season, and continue on for the next 3 or 4 weeks to the 350 miles. So but yeah, this is the bird that came home the second day. Both birds are siblings that finished the race for the 200 miles race. They're both siblings, so that tells me something good about them. And I wanted to show you guys the eyes of these birds, okay? I don't know if you guys can see. I was checking out the eyes of these birds for the last few weeks to determine if there is anything that is different from them than all the other birds, or whatever else, from all the birds, to see in case, you know what I'm saying, eyes do matter or something. And what I noticed about these eyes is that if you zoom in very, very closely, well, actually, it's gonna have to be a little closer than that, but yeah, if you zoom in very, very closely, I don't know if you can see or not. Can you zoom in? Like zoom, zoom, like not, like it's super zoom. Yeah. Okay. So eyes like that, they seem to do a lot better homing. But when you actually look closer in there, there's another layer around the eyes. Okay, and somehow those kind of eyes, they seem to do good in as we go the distance for some reason. Now, this is a young bird that we're gonna fly at the 20 miles today, but if you can see the eyes, if you zoom in, it's a little bit different. Okay. These birds' eyes are a little bit different. I don't know if it makes any difference. But yeah, they're a little bit different. And then the meat on this one, it's a little bit more purplish. It's a little bit more purplish. This bird's a little bit fat, so it looks a little bit more purplish. So I'm thinking she probably ate too much of the good stuff. This bird's a little bit fat also. They got a little bit too much meat on them, so they're a little purple. See that? That they're a little bit on the purple side. Okay.
Come on, let's go. Let's go. Only two birds left. The third bird is the unbanded bird. Only two of my birds are left for this 250 miles.
I was coming this way, I see my three birds fly past that way, going probably about a good 55 miles an hour. So they should beat us home today, the three birds. But I'm releasing these young birds here today. Let's go. Let's go. Yeah, so. Can't even see the mountains. The mountains usually just right there, but you can't even see the mountains today because of all the wildfire smoke. Here they go. Get that little dot right there. And there.
these old birds out. Let's go, let's go. Make it over that hill. Hurry up. Up over that hill. I need to fly higher than that. Oh well. They'll eventually get home.
Guys, that's our day. All birds got back in a timely manner. We're gonna turn off the lights now. We've already given them plenty of food and water. Stay tuned for 250 miles race this weekend. We have two birds left only in this 250 miles race. We hope that these birds will make it home. We're gonna test the qualities to the maximum to see what they can do. We just hope that, you know, that they fly high, like how they're flying when they're training. Today the birds are flying really high and pretty fast. So we're hoping that the birds will do the same on race day and get home quickly. Whether they win or not, we don't count on winning. We just want our birds to be able to complete the 350 miles young birds race. So this week is 250 miles, and then we got two more weeks after that. We hope that our two birds will finish all the way and be there all the way until the 350 miles, to finish 350 miles, to qualify to go into young bird season. That's the only way for us to determine whether our breeding is good. Okay, this is one of them that's gonna be going to the 250 miles race. You see the chip ring band there. Okay, this is one of them. It's number 9. This is the good one. And you know, that's our last hope with that one and the sibling of that one, number 10. So we'll see how it goes this weekend. Stay tuned.